Welcome. In this video, we're going to show you how to create a custom photo note card in Photoshop that you can then print on Red River's line of pre-scored inkjet papers. This tutorial is for PC users with a full version of Photoshop. Some of your screens may look slightly different, but the workflow and steps will be the same. First, you can download blank card templates from our website. Go to redriverpaper.com/templates. Click on the link and download the zip file to your hard drive. Once the zip file is on your computer, you'll need to unzip the contents. Right-click on the file and choose Extract. All versions of Windows come with this function. Once extracted, you'll have the templates in a folder. Double-click on the folder to view its contents. Templates with the word Land will create cards that open vertically. Templates with the word vert are used for cards that open like a book. When you've selected and opened a template, you'll see this note that has some helpful reminders. Begin by locating the Layers palette. If you do not see it, press F7 on your keyboard. Click on the eye to turn this layer off. The blue grids around the edge of the template represent the printable area and margins of most inkjet printers. Keep all of your text and graphics inside these lines. The middle guide represents where your card will fold. Now it's time to open a photo. So go to the File menu and select Open, and choose an image for your card. Now, you'll resize the photo to fit properly on the card. A sizing guide is available in the written layout instructions on our website. In this case, I'm using a 7x10 card and I want to put a 4x6 image on the front outside. So click on the Crop tool and change the dimensions up at the top to the size that you'd like. Now you can crop the image. Now put the photo and the layout next to each other on the screen. Activate the Move tool. You can also hit V on your keyboard. Click and hold the mouse and drag the photo onto your layout like this. Now you can close the photo. The photo now becomes a new layer on your layout that you can freely move around. Place the photo where you'd like it on the layout. Here the photo is in the middle of the printable area on the front of the card. At this point, I could simply make a print, but I'd like to put some text on the back of the card. Here we have the front outside of my card, and this will be the back outside of my card. Choose the Text tool or click T on the keyboard. I choose a font and then type a message. Because the text is a separate layer, you can move it anywhere you wish. Push V on the keyboard for the Move tool, and once again, you can move the text. On this type of layout, the text needs to be upside down in order to print properly. So go to the Edit menu, choose Transform, and then rotate 180 degrees, and the text is upside down. The basic layout is now complete, and you can proceed to the print process. Go to the File menu and choose Print. This brings up Photoshop's Print dialog. Go to the Printer drop-down and select your machine. Now click Page Setup, which will start your printer property dialog. Click on the main tab and choose your media type. This is based on the type of paper that you're using. Under Print Quality, set it to the desired setting and go to the Page Setup tab. Go to the Page Size drop-down to the bottom under Custom. Now here you'll set the width to the smallest dimension of your paper and the height to the longest dimension of your paper and click OK. Click on the main tab, verify your settings, and click OK again. Photoshop's print preview will have changed to reflect the new paper size you entered. Load your printer with paper and now you can click Print.